Do you struggle from insomnia and thyroid disease? You've tried everything, but nothing worked. And you are searching for the great natural remedy in order to fix this insomnia, but also help your thyroid disease. Because maybe you've been thinking like, why does it happen? Like, why do I suffer from this, horrible insomnia and thyroid disease? Is it like connected to thyroid disease? How can I fix it and what are the best natural remedies? Believe me or not, but used to I struggled from exactly the same thing, and I found out 11 best remedies that helped me to fix insomnia, and they also helped like tons of my clients and patients. So that's why I'm making this video here, and I would like to give these remedies for you so you can just copy paste them to your life and fix this problem. So insomnia in general happens in thyroid disease because you have some form of imbalance when it comes to your adrenal health. Adrenal glands are small glands that are on the top of your kidney, and they are situated on the top of your kidney, and if they don't work properly, you have an imbalance of cortisol and also adrenaline. So those are the two main hormones, among the others, that are produced by adrenal glands, and they can really, really mess up with your sleep. So you don't want to have, imbalances of this hormone. So how can you fix these hormones? First tip: do not drink coffee after 2 p.m. Coffee is very bad for your adrenal glands. I understand that you want to have one cup of tea or coffee in the morning, but do not have it in the afternoon, guys, because this really stimulates your adrenal glands, like is messing up with your cortisol, adrenaline, and that's why you have hard time in falling asleep, okay? So this is the first tip: coffee only in the morning. Second tip is use blue light blocking glasses. You don't want excess of the blue light in the evening because this blue light is spiking up your cortisol, and this prevents you from falling asleep. So strategically you want to use this blue light blocking glasses just before going to bed. Third tip is make sure to use eye mask and earplugs. The same logic here: you don't want this, external noises or like some light source coming inside to your room, and you want to absolutely block it. You want the cortisol to decrease and you want to block the blue light. So use this two, super simple fixes. Another remedy, fourth remedy, is a bath with Epsom salts, but also essential oils, like for example, lavender oil. These oils, but also Epsom salts, they help you to reduce the inflammation. And if you suffer from high inflammation in thyroid disease, which you usually do, this will help you to decrease inflammation, improve your adrenal health, improve your thyroid health, and in this way you can decrease cortisol levels, you can calm down and fall asleep much easier. So this is a great remedy. Fifth remedy is to have some tryptophan. Tryptophan is one of the amino acids that is needed for the production of the neurotransmitters for sleep. So this tryptophan you can either supplement, but you can also get it from food. Like for example, turkey is rich in tryptophan. You can have a turkey breast around 200 grams before going to bed. This is more than enough to get the optimal levels of tryptophan, so you can fall asleep much easier, okay? Sixth tip is to implement some supplements, like for example, magnesium. Magnesium is great when it comes to this, calming effect on your body, but also to falling asleep much easier because it calms down to your body and it relaxes you. So the best form of magnesium when it comes to sleep, I would say, is magnesium glycinate. You can have 400 milligrams of this magnesium glycinate just before going to bed. But if you have also problem with, for example, constipation, you can even get magnesium citrate. It will work well as well, okay? Seventh tip is other supplements, like for example, valerian root, or for example, melissa. Those are the natural herbs that can also help you to optimize your sleep quality. You can get them either in the supplement, pill form, or you can get them as a tea. It should work well. Or if you want to take it to the next level, you can even get our formula, Calm and Sleep, from our website, h-boss.com. This formula is full in natural herbs, but also supplements, and also melatonin. Melatonin is a great, stronger supplement when it comes to sleep regulation, and this can also help you to optimize your sleep. Just a small, disclaimer here: do not take this formula infinitely, but take it for 6 to 8 weeks and then have like 2 to 3 weeks of break. This is because we don't want your body to get used to supplementation. You actually want to help your body, then make a break, help your body, and in the meantime, you want to work on your body, okay? Another tip is to use bone broth. Bone broth is an amazing remedy for your gut. If you have some form of gut imbalance, this will also have an impact on your sleep. So you want to drink 2 to 3 cups of bone broth every day. You will find a great recipe for bone broth on our website, thyroidboss.com. So check it out, and this should help you. Another remedy, do not have simple carbohydrates just before going to sleep. Simple carbs like, for example, sugar, you know, pasta, and these things rich in gluten, some waffles, these kind of things, they mess up with your blood sugar and they really prevent you from falling asleep properly. So do not have these kind of things before going to bed. Preferably remove them from your diet because they are not healthy for you. Another tip is actually using 1 teaspoon of honey just before going to bed. So this remedy works very well. It's an exception to, you know, this simple carbohydrates that I was saying. And you can be using 1 teaspoon and I would say 30-20 minutes after your last meal, so after your dinner. This should help your body to fall asleep much easier. Another tip is using celery. So celery is rich in minerals, in electrolytes, like mainly potassium. And this should also help you to fall asleep much easier. So you can actually consume 3, 4, 5 celery stalks just before going to bed. And again, after your dinner, this should really help you to fall asleep much easier. Another thing is to assess your thyroid medication. You don't want to be on the wrong type of thyroid medication. Like, for example, some medications like T3 or combined, you know, medications like T3, T4, or for example, NDT, which also have, you know, higher amounts of T3 hormone, which is this active hormone that boosts your metabolism and gives you energy. This is very good, but if you're having too much energy already and if you have problems with falling asleep, this medication will actually be a wrong medication for you. So make sure always to consult 2 doctors, preferably consult a functional medicine doctor, because he will help you to choose the best medication for you. Like, for example, instead of T3, you can get some alternative, you know, T4 medication, and in this way you are decreasing T3 levels and you are falling asleep much easier. Another tip is the dose of the medication. Always make sure that you are on the right dose, because too high dose can also put at risk your sleep and you will have hard time with falling asleep, okay? So this is another thing. And the last one is timing of the medication. So if your doctor told you that you have to take medication before bed, you may want to change it for the morning, because before going to bed, when this medication is being absorbed and you are getting this, you know, T4, T3, you don't want these hormones in the evening, because if you already have problem with falling asleep, this will just give you more insomnia. So you want to take these hormones rather in the morning in order to get this, you know, boost in the morning, but fall asleep much easier in the evening. I think that's everything. So subscribe below and I will see you guys in the next video.